Hi friends, this is Preeti. So today I'm going to discuss about autonomic nervous system. Nervous system is divided into two parts, central nervous system and peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system includes brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system is divided into autonomic nervous system and somatic nervous system. Autonomic nervous system is divided again into two parts, sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, now we'll study the differences between autonomic and somatic. Okay, autonomic means it is involuntary. Involuntary means the functions are the actions. Okay, the actions are not under our control. Okay, it means example heartbeat, respiration, peristalsis, all this. Okay, they are not under our control. If we take somatic, it is voluntary. Voluntary means the actions are under our control. Example, if we want to move our hand or leg, or if we want to do something, okay, it is under our control. Okay, next, here, except skeletal muscle, all other organs are supplied with this autonomic nervous system, whereas skeletal muscle is somatic. And here the nerve fibers are pre-ganglion are myelinated and post-ganglion are non-myelinated. And in somatic, both are myelinated. And the neurotransmitters involved in autonomic are acetylcholine and norepinephrine. So acetylcholine is involved in parasympathetic, whereas norepinephrine is involved in sympathetic. Okay. And in somatic, the neurotransmitter involved is acetylcholine. Okay, now here we'll see the difference between myelinated and non-myelinated. Okay, so if we see this, this is the axon of a neuron. So this is the myelin sheath. The difference, the gap between these two myelin sheath is called as nodes of Ranvier. Okay, if in the presence of myelin sheath, the passage of impulse through the axon is very fast, because what happens is here the impulse will jump like this. Okay, like this it will transfer. Only at this gaps the impulse is transmitted. Whereas in non-myelinated fibers, as this myelin sheath is not there, the impulse will pass this throughout this axon. So it takes some time. So it is a slow response. Okay, in non-myelinated fibers, the passage of impulse is slow when compared to the myelinated fibers. So this is the difference. So here we can see, sometimes we get confused with the efferent neurons and afferent neurons. Okay, efferent neurons means the neurons which connect from central nervous system to sensory organs. Okay, it means the neurons which take impulses from our brain or spinal cord to the sensory organs. It is carried by efferent, whereas the impulses carried from sensory organs to brain are called as efferent. Okay, efferent. Remember, like efferent, A means away. Okay, away from the sensory organs. Out of these two, just remember one. If you remember efferent, you can write the opposite one is obviously the efferent one. Okay, A for away. So away from the sensory organs, it carry impulses away from the sensory organs. It means towards the central nervous system. That's it. Okay, so now we'll see the sympathetic and parasympathetic. Okay, here you can see this is a preganglion and these are the postganglion. So if this is the synapse, the front one is a preganglion and the other side is the postganglion. Okay, as we have seen, the neurotransmitter involved in the sympathetic is norepinephrine, whereas in parasympathetic it is acetylcholine. So here what happens, the preganglion will release acetylcholine. Okay, all the preganglions will release only acetylcholine, whereas a postganglion, okay, the postganglion in sympathetic releases norepinephrine majorly, whereas it also sometimes releases acetylcholine, okay, and in adrenal medulla it releases adrenaline. Okay, all the preganglionic neurons produce acetylcholine, whereas the difference comes at postganglionic. In sympathetic nervous system, mainly the postganglion release norepinephrine, whereas in parasympathetic it release acetylcholine. Okay, so now here you can see the length. In sympathetic, the peak preganglion is short, whereas postganglion is long. In parasympathetic, the preganglion is long and postganglion is short. Okay. And next we come to somatic. In somatic, there is only a single neuron. There is no post and pre. Okay. And that is myelinated. Whereas in autonomic, pre are myelinated and post are non-myelinated. So here you can see pre-myelinated, post non-myelinated. Whereas here there is a single neuron. Here you can see there is a single neuron and it releases acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter. Okay. Okay. Now we'll study about sympathetic and parasympathetic. Sympathetic is located in thoracolumbar, whereas parasympathetic is located in craniosacral. Okay. If these parts are first, it starts with medulla and then cervix and then thorax, lumbar and sacral. So first cranium, from brain, these parts are of spinal cord. So starting here, there will be brain, cranium and then medulla, cervix, thorax, lumbar and sacral. Okay, so in the sympathetic nervous system, this thoracolumbar part are related to the sympathetic nervous system, whereas craniosacral is related to the parasympathetic. Just remember that. Okay, this is active during stressful conditions and prepare the body to face them. So they are called as fight or flight response. Okay. They are mainly active during stressful conditions. Whereas in parasympathetic, they are mainly active during relaxing times. And they are called as rest and digest response. So here in sympathetic, all organs are connected to thorax except digestive system and urogenital system. So these two are connected to lumbar. Okay. So what happens here is, previously we have seen preganglion and postganglion. So first, suppose we take digestive system. Okay. So digestive system. Now what happens? The preganglion neurons from lumbar, okay, they connect to the postganglionic neurons. These postganglionic neurons are further connected to the digestive system. So this is the connection. From lumbar, the neurons connect to the digestive system. Okay. This lumbar, the neurons originated from the lumbar, connect to the digestive system and urogenital system. Whereas for all other organs, it is connected through thorax. Okay. Like this, the neurons are connected to the organs from the nervous system. Okay. And here in peripheral nervous system, it is mainly active during relaxing times. So it is also called as rest and digest response. So it is mainly located in cranium and sacral. Cranium, all organs are connected to the cranial nerves, whereas sacral, only urogenital system. Okay. And next we see the differences. So here previously we have seen SNS originates in the thoracic and lumbar regions of spinal cord, whereas PNS cranium of the brain and sacral of spinal cord. Okay, its ganglions are linked up to form a chain, whereas here they are isolated. Okay, and here the preganglionic are short and post are long. So this point also we have seen previously. And here the norepinephrine is produced at the terminal ends of the postganglionic fibers at the synapse on the effector organ. Hence the system is called adrenergic. So we have seen in sympathetic, the postganglion will release norepinephrine, whereas the pre will release acetylcholine. Majorly it releases noradrenaline. In minor cases, it can also release acetylcholine. And whereas in adrenal medulla, it releases adrenaline. Whereas in parasympathetic, acetylcholine is produced at the terminal ends of this postganglionic fibers. Okay, and this is active during stressful conditions, and here it is active during relaxing times. And here the overall effect is excitatory and stimulating. Okay, sympathetic. And here it is inhibitory. Okay. These parasympathetic shows inhibitory actions, whereas sympathetic shows excitatory and stimulating actions. So now we see what are those excitatory actions and what are the inhibitory actions. Okay, here we can see sympathetic is a fight or a flight response, and parasympathetic is a rest and digest response. So here you can see I. So if it is I, means here the neurons from thoracic part connect to the eye. Okay, then here what is happening, there is a dilation of pupil. So when norepinephrine released from the post ganglion and acts on the receptors present on eye, it leads to the dilation of this pupil of eye. Okay, dilation of pupil of eye is also called as mydriasis. Okay, and whereas here there is release of acetylcholine from the postganglion, so there is a constriction. Okay, and heart, there is an increase in rate and force of contraction, whereas here it's opposite. So it is excitatory, it is inhibitory. Blood vessels, contraction. Inhibitory means again dilation. Digestive tract, increased peristalsis, whereas here digestive tract, except, okay, this is exception, or digestive tract, it shows inhibition. Okay, and whereas here it is increase in peristalsis. And salivary glands inhibits the salivary secretion, whereas here it stimulates. Pancreas also, it inhibits the activity of pancreas, and here it stimulates, whereas in lungs relaxes the bronchi. Okay, and here it constricts. Kidney increases the secretion of renin, whereas here it decreases the secretion of renin. Urinary bladder inhibits the emptying bladder, whereas here it promotes the emptying of the bladder. So these functions are very, very important. Okay. And next we'll see which receptor is, means what type of receptors are present on these different organs, eye, heart, blood vessels, digestive tract. Okay, then you'll get an idea how the response is seen. Okay, the next video I will explain about that. We'll start sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, this is just introduction. Since inter we are studying about this, okay, central nervous system, peripheral, autonomic, somatic, sympathetic, parasympathetic. Okay, pharmacy, what we'll study, what are the drugs acting on that receptors. Okay, so mainly we'll study about the drugs acting on that receptors. Okay, so thank you so much for watching my video. Please like, share, subscribe and comment. We'll meet in our next video.